Good morning, everyone. Now I am going to discuss some definition of the directional derivative of a scalar point function and how we can find out the directional derivative of given scalar point function with the direction along the vector or the normal to the surface or the joining of two points. In such cases, we discuss the directional derivative of scalar point function. The derivative is nothing but the rate of change of the function is called as the derivative. Here, the function is a scalar point function. With that, we can find out the directional derivative, means the derivative of that function along the direction. Okay, in that we find out the directional derivative, means the directional derivative of a scalar point function pi at a point p of x, y, z in the direction of unit vector e bar is e bar dot grad pi or e bar dot del pi. Here unit vector means e bar is a unit vector. If in the problem pi is a scalar point function and a bar is a vector, that is the, we can find out the directional derivative of the function in the direction a bar, means we can find out the unit vector. That unit vector form is a bar by modulus of a bar, and we know that del pi is nothing but that is a grad pi. Grad pi is equal to I dou pi by dou x plus j dou pi by dou y plus k dou pi by dou z. Here a vector is a direct vector form. In the second case, it is a first case. In the second case, suppose pi is a scalar point function and we can, in the direction of normal to the surface, that is, we can find out the normal vector. That normal vector to the surface is, that is del f. Unit vector, that is unit normal vector, means e bar is equal to n bar by modulus of n bar. Okay, here two cases are there. One is pi is a scalar point function in two cases. One is along the directly given the vector, that is a bar. In that case, we can find out the unit vector. That unit vector form is, we know that a bar by modulus of a bar. If the direction of the vector is directly not given, just they are asking the directional derivative of the function pi in the direction of the normal to the surface, means we can find out normal to the surface, that is in the direction, means we know that the normal vector to the surface n bar is del pi, that is nothing but grad pi. Next, to find out the unit vector, that is equal to n bar by modulus of n bar. It is the second case. The third case is pi is a scalar point function at point p and q is a another point. Q is a another point. But we can find out the directional derivative along the PQ line. Means we can find out a vector that is equal to OQ minus OP vector, that is equal to PQ vector. We can take from the origin to P point, that is a position vector of P. And the origin to the Q is position vector of Q. In that, we can find out with the points, two vectors OQ and OP, the difference of two vectors is equal to the direction vector along the P and Q, that is A bar. Then in the same case, unit position vector E bar along the points P and Q means E bar is equal to modulus of A bar by modulus of A bar. The same case, but here the cases are different. Directly vector is given. Another one is the direction in the normal to the surface. The third one is the direction along the two points. Okay, just you remember what are the differences in three cases means. If the vector is given means directly we can find out the unit vector and applying the directional derivative, that is E bar dot grad pi or E bar dot del pi. Why? Because E bar is a vector. The second case, normal to the surface, in these two surfaces are given at the different points or at the same points. That is depends on the given problem. But normal means the normal vector of the surface is the del pi. That is, the case is n vector is equal to del pi. And further, unit normal vector E bar is equal to n vector by modulus of n vector, the same unit vector formula. The third one, pi is a scalar point function at P point and Q is the another point. Then we can find out the directional derivative of the scalar point function with the two points means you can find out the position vector along the P and Q means first we can take the position vectors from the origin to two points OP and OQ. Then the difference of two points is equal to the, that is the directional vector. Okay. Then unit vector is equal to A bar by modulus of A bar. Okay. If you remember these three cases, then you can easy to find out the directional derivative of a scalar point function. It is very, very important in the examination. Okay. If you like this video, then you can subscribe my channel, that is Arudra Maths Academy. And if you like this video, you share to your friends also. Okay. Thank you.